Oh, come on, that's ridiculous. Get on me with ah!
Hey, hey.
That's so unfair.
What do you mean it's unfair?
He's cheating.
No way. He does not cheat. He has never cheated in his entire life. And you have a weight advantage.
Hey, mother. What kind of weight advantage? Oh, you mean this weight advantage?
Yeah, baby.
You like that?
I do like that kind of weight advantage. Come here.
Hi.
Hi. Mm. Ew. Dad.
Ew. So gross. Mm. It's so yucky. Oh, my God.
What? Get a room.
Mm. Oh, shit.
No, no,
I'm
no.
Sorry. Hold on. It's Bryce. I'll be right back.
Hey, what up, handsome?
Hey, what's up? You throwing the ball around with a little one?
Yeah.
All right, well, listen, sorry to bother you on a Sunday.
Ah, it's no big deal. What's going on?
I've got this work to do.
We've got to deal with it. One of the accounts is falling apart.
We have some new information, but I think we have to walk the client through it.
Okay.
Okay, what about tomorrow morning? Is that good?
Yeah, Monday it is.
Great.
Well, say hi to the little fella for me.
Of course.
Okay, mate. All right, bye.
All right, bye.
Dear? All right, everything in order?
Yep.
Thank you. We're good to go? Oh. My fellow Americans, today in America, a teacher spent extra time with a student who needed it and did her part to help lift America's graduation rate to levels that have been unsurpassed in the past three decades. An entrepreneur flipped the lights on in her high-tech startup company and did her part to help add to the more than 8 million new jobs that American businesses have created over the past 4 years. An auto worker fine-tuned some of the best, most fuel-efficient cars in the world and did his part to help wean America off of her dependence on foreign oil. Now, innovators in America's top industries are leading the world on a path towards a brighter future. And it's time that our sworn leaders.
It smells good, babe.
Here to safeguard
I'm starving.
Our constitutional rights follow suit. Since the Cold War, our government has employed a task force whose sole responsibility
is to
monitor the American people. Now, for decades, they've kept a close watch on us as we've slowly given up our rights.
Yeah, there's enough time.
Our privacy.
You're such a pessimist.
No, I'm a realist.
For perceived protection.
4 years isn't that long. People make empty promises, you know.
Domestic threat great enough to warrant the violation of the rights of the American people. And while the U.S. Constitution contains no express right to that end,
our
founding fathers saw fit to draft the 9th Amendment of the Bill of Rights.
I think you owe me one, don't you?
And I quote.
Hmm?
I might.
I guess it's like that. That's right.
Okay, Poppy. Oh, by the way. No. Stop it. Come on.
Where do you think he learns it from?
Now, the 9th Amendment is clearly meant to protect privacy.
Oh, my God. Can you go help him wash up?
Sure.
What?
Well, I'm just looking at you. Nah.
There is no excuse for the blatant invasion of privacy incurred by the American people at the hands of the NSA, the FBI, CIA, or any other special intelligence task force. My fellow Americans, I will continue to work tirelessly to ensure that the privacy of the American people is upheld, and that the American people are neither surveilled nor monitored, and that we all feel safe in our homes, secure in our streets, and in our businesses. My fellow Americans, thank you for tuning in tonight and listening. May God bless you, and may God bless America.
Whoa! Easy there, buddy.
I think it's a little bit past your bedtime.
No way.
No way? No way. What are you kidding me? Get over here, you little munchkin. Boom. All right. Time for bed. All right, Spider Monkey. Bedtime.
But Dad, I'm not tired.
All right, I'll tell you what. If you don't tell your mother, I'll read you another chapter, okay?
Pinky promise.
Pinky promise. You know that's real, right? Hold on. Another chapter it is. So, oh, this is a good one. This is not what I asked for. This is not what I planned. When I said, okay, you can bury me up to my neck in sand. Go to sleep. I'll turn the lights out. You gotta be fucking kidding me with this trash. Go get the wife.
Got it.
I got the front.
I'll go grab the kid.
Come on. I know you're out there. I can hear you. Look, I don't know any answers to your questions. Please, just let me go.
Why don't you just tell us the truth?
Look, I'm not lying.
Your name is Stephen White, and you're an operative for the agency.
My name is John Niles. I'm an insurance salesman, that's it. Son of a fuck!
I'm telling you the truth, man. I swear to God, I'm an insurance agent. What do you want from me?
Fuck this shit.
What do you know
about Operation Jackknife?
I don't know anything about Operation Jackknife, man.
What do you know about Operation Jackknife?
I have no idea about that.
Who's your contact?
I got no fucking contact.
Who's your contact, huh?
You got the wrong guy.
Give me something. You gotta give me something. We're gonna do this all night until you give me something. Who are your contacts, hmm? Come on, buddy. Tell me something.
I don't have any fucking contacts. Yeah, I don't have any fucking contacts.
You don't have any contacts, huh? Who are you working for, huh? Make it easy on yourself. Come on. Speak up.
You can torture me all day, fool. I don't have any answers for you.
I can't hear you. Who are you working with?
I don't know what to tell you. I'm a fucking insurance salesman.
All right. Yeah, all right. You're an insurance salesman, right?
I'm an insurance salesman!
You're an insurance salesman. I got it.
Yeah, that's it!
I hope you have life insurance, motherfucker. We're gonna get something out of this guy. You're a fucking dead man if you don't start talking. Come on, give me something.
Wait!
You fucking confess.
All right. All right. You're right. My name is Stephen White, okay? I used to be an agent. I retired. They forced me out of the agency. I have no fucking idea what Operation Jackknife is. I have no idea. I don't work for anybody anymore, okay? I'm a family man. I got a wife, a kid, that's it. I swear to God.
Hi, babe.
What do you want from me, huh? Rebecca?
Listen to me. Is Mark with you? Huh? Do what I say, okay? Everything's gonna be okay. I'm gonna come
get you. Okay? Hold on. I love you. Rebecca!
You're getting the picture now, Johnny.
Yeah. Don't fuck with my family. You understand me?
You are not gonna do shit. You're not giving the orders here, pal. We are. And we'll let your family go after you do something for us.
You mess with my family, I swear to God, I'm gonna hunt you down.
You fucking be easy, buddy.
I'm gonna heal you.
All in good time.
Look at my family, I swear to God.
Prep this son of a bitch for transport.
Your family, their lives are in your hands.
Your life is in my hands. You hurt my family. I will find you. I will hunt you down, and I will kill you. Do you understand me?
You ain't gonna do a goddamn thing!
Number 3, step forward, please. Is that the man?
No.
You're sure?
I'm sure.
Step back. Number 4, step forward, please. Is this the man?
That's him.
It was dark. This is the man who climbed in your window.
That's him.
You sure?
I'm sure.
Take number 4 to a conference room, please.
Detective Weston, can you come with me, please?
I'll be right back. Excuse me. Well, that looks like precision shooting. We got 5 dead bodies and enough physical evidence to fill a couple of evidence lockers.
God damn it.
Tell me about it. I'm dizzy just thinking about all the paperwork that's gonna come from this one.
Who was the primary assailant?
We got a call from a couple kids, thought they heard firecrackers. Needless to say, wasn't firecrackers.
These kids gonna need a lot of therapy in the near future, huh?
Probably.
Where are you going? Get back here, I'm talking to you. You got a problem with me?
No.
Carl, don't you fix your fucking name tag. Get the fuck out of here. Detective Walsh.
Detective?
Walk me through it.
Well, evidence is scarce, and CSI has not shown up yet. We've pulled what we can from their driver's licenses based on time of death and weapons used. We can give you an approximate idea of what we think
happened. At this stage of the game, approximate is fine. Let's go. Come on.
Okay, so here we have Jim Lee and Damon Reeves. Jim was an accountant. Damon, he worked at a bank. The thing with Damon is his wallet was missing. Assuming he actually carried a wallet, we're thinking the guy who killed him also took his wallet. His weapons were missing as well.
So our boy is armed. Considering the carnage, I'm not surprised.
Over here we have Sean Reeves, Mike Power, and Martin Chance. Sean was a teacher, Mike was a vet, and Martin, well, he was a nurse.
That's a pretty rough-looking nurse. How about this guy, the black gun?
Well, that's the interesting thing. See, we can't find anything on this guy. When we pulled up the driver's license we found, it came up with a Peter Morris. The thing is, the Peter Morris we found has actually been dead for over 10 years. We'll know more when we get the test results back.
What about the guy in the chair? What do you have on him?
Well, what we can tell so far, it looks like he single-handedly killed every single guy here. We have no idea who this guy is. Once we get the test results back from his blood, urine, and whatever he had for lunch, we should know a little bit more.
So they beat the shit out of this guy, and he still manages to get loose and kill all 5 of them and then just walk out of here. Oh, that's just perfect. We should close this case by lunch tomorrow. Fuck. Why is this funny?
Officers found that with a bunch of kids.
Well, that's a high-end cell phone for a kid, isn't it?
That's exactly what the officer said. We ran some tests on the last calls made, and they match up with the exact time of the victim's death. On top of that, we have a John and Rebecca Niles address. We don't have anyone here with that name.
Did you send a black and white to this address?
It's en route.
Well, you better send backup, because if John Niles is the guy who was in this chair, it's gonna be a fucking disaster.
So what are you thinking? It's some sort of undercover operation gone wrong?
I have no idea, but these motherfucking fake IDs are getting me pissed off. Yeah, Weston. Sorry, sir.
Carl, assist Detective Walsh. I can't hear you. Wait till I'm outside. Hang on.
Take the next exit. Let's get out of this mess.
There you are. No, I couldn't hear you inside, and now I'm going outside. Marie, I couldn't get any reception inside. Now I got it. Is everything all right?
Marie, call 911.
Thank you.
am really impressed, Johnny.
You aren't rusty at all.
You heard them. I swear my life I'll kill you.
After what you pulled at the warehouse? I don't doubt that. Listen, John.
This is simple. Do what we ask, when we ask. All right?
This is a time-sensitive situation, so no more games.
You don't need them. All you need is me. Tell me what you want me to do.
We'll be in touch. Oh, and John, you might want to
leave your house right now.
Dispatch, we're on site at 15935 Dawson Lane. It's pretty quiet. We're going to go check it out.
Hold up. Door's open.
Drop your gun! Drop your gun, man! Drop your gun! Drop your fucking gun, man! Think about what you're doing, man.
The hell do you think you're doing?
The fuck? Don't be stupid. Think about what you're doing.
Here you are, Captain.
Your itineraries are in the final draft of your remarks.
Thank you, Roger. Any updates on that CIA BT-85 legislation? You know, I want to move quickly on this, as we've made privacy our central theme and main focus.
I can have your copy, sir, in a couple hours.
Not good. You have my glasses, Roger?
No, I don't have them, sir.
All right, well, looks like that's going to have to wait. Cheers.
Mr. President, 5 minutes.
Thank you, Roger.
Let me help you with that.
Ta-da!
Almost.
You know how much I hate these dog and pony shows.
Oh, I know.
Be a love and go for me.
Oh, you'll be fine.
Says you.
Mm-hmm. Oh, oops. Can't have the most powerful man in the world showing up to this dog and pony show wearing, oh, good, lipstick.
Well, might be an improvement.
I wouldn't think so.
I still feel like it needs some help.
That's me.
I need to meet me in the spot in 1 hour. Yeah.
Be there.
Look, I'm trying to tell you what happened. This guy, he went through us like we weren't even there. Cut right through us. Shit, he had me dead to rights. It could have killed me. Shit, for that matter, he could have killed us both.
Just sit down.
Green?
Waters.
It doesn't change the fact that we have what used to be a warehouse full of dead cops.
Well, I mean, seriously, ask yourself. If this guy is such a stone-cold killer, then why the hell did he go through the trouble of taking us down with his hands instead of using a gun? I mean, Christ, he had a gun on each hand by the time he was done dancing with us.
I don't know. That's what I have to find out.
Well, sir, I'm just saying, I think you should look a little deeper because I really doubt this is your guy.
Well, for the moment, he's my only lead, which makes him my only suspect. The real question is, who is John Niles?
fuck did you get me involved in?
We had solid intelligence. There was a major threat on some government officials. We wanted to get you on the inside to find out what they were planning.
You didn't tell me the risk factor. You threw me in blind.
We didn't know the facts.
Oh, you didn't know the facts? Well, now people are dead. And they have my family. You threw me into the fucking lion's den.
And I apologize. We didn't know they'd get your family.
Do they know I'm a plant?
No. Absolutely impossible.
I did this because I owed you. You said it'd be a no-risk operation. They're my fucking family, Mike. That's not low risk.
I know. I apologize for that. Stand by me. I'll give you my word. We get your family back. The men you took pictures of?
Mm-hmm.
They report to this man. David Marino.
And we met. Who is he?
Not only does he do a lot of killing, he enjoys it.
Who's he work for?
The CIA.
You kidding me?
Be ready at 12.
He's got his men hunting everybody. He gets to the president.
So this is Operation Jackknife.
You know, until recently, it was just theory. The president signed his own death warrant when he tried to decommission the CIA. But now they want to make sure that you're involved.
Why the fuck do they want me involved?
You're the perfect scapegoat, John. You're off everybody's radar.
This is happening.
Yeah, but we got you covered.
They're going to fucking hang me out to dry. They're going to leave me on that fucking roof, Mike.
John, you fucked up. You got to pull it together. Your family side of it will deal with. But you got to stay off the radar. Now listen, if anything gets too hot, this is your failsafe. It's got everything about the president, CIA, Marino, 9/11, the fucking works. This is your get out of jail free card, John. This motherfucker will save your life. So guard it with your life.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Let's go, John!
Take the roof, John.
Yep.
Here. It's in the keys. There's a car downstairs. Go!
Go!
Out cold.
You okay, buddy?
Dad!
You've had your proof of life. Now, the next 30 seconds will determine whether your family lives or dies, so you better be pretty fucking convincing. Why did you contact this man?
Price was my handler back when I was an agent. I knew I couldn't go to the cops. He was the only one I could turn to.
What did he tell you?
He said the guys at the warehouse were CIA. But he had no fucking idea why I was involved.
And?
That's it. Your goon showed up.
I suppose since we don't have the luxury of time, we're gonna have to trust you. You find anything?
Nothing. Price didn't have anything on his computer. No mention of either Jackknife or Niles.
All right, we move forward. John, you do what we say when we say it, and your family will be okay. This will all be over. All right, go ahead. Sweet dreams, John.
Everything ready, Marino?
All in good time. Proceed with Jackknife as planned.
I don't have to remind you what's at stake here, do I, Agent?
Yeah, I know you'll kill me.
The surveillance program is a critical part of our national defense system. This bill our president passed is not only unconstitutional, but it undermines the exact fiber of all our defense organizations. You understand that, right? Our enemies are no longer faceless foreigners. We have snakes in the garden, Marino. Wolves at our gates. And we must do anything and everything in our power to protect this country. We can no longer trust the president to do so. Don't disappoint me. Don't let your country down.
We'll be in touch.
Roger, I'm going over the BT-85 document and everything looks good. So I'll sign off when I wrap up this circus. Just make sure to let the director know it's being signed. It won't go into effect immediately, so I want a smooth transition. It'd be best for everyone, all right? I don't want any fallout on this one. Thank you.
You getting the picture now, Johnny? Move east along 42nd Street.
turn north.
Post is on site. We'll meet you at location Foxtrot.
Why are you doing this to me?
Sometimes a great sacrifice is necessary. When the leader is weak and you're in combat, you remove him in order to survive.
You're never gonna get away with this.
Look. People still argue as to whether or not Oswald acted alone, or if he even took the shot. At the end of the day,
it didn't matter. The president was still
dead.
Pick up his rifle.
What if I can't do it?
Can't is the cancer of can. Now, for the sake of your family,
I suggest you give it your best effort.
The clock is ticking, John. We don't have time to debate this.
And you're the best there is.
Take the shot, John.
Take the shot, John. Your kid's gonna suffer.
Fuck you. Just take the goddamn shot, Niall. Stop being a pussy.
Negative, sir. No sign of him anywhere. About to do a sweep of the perimeter.
It's done. The president's down. You got your Patsy. Now release my family.
You're not giving the fucking orders here, pal. You got that?
Let my family go now. I'll walk to the nearest television station. I'll tell them what I did and why I did it.
You really think anybody's gonna believe you? Especially after what you've done?
I'll shout so loud they'll have to listen.
If you want me, let them go.
Niles, you're in no position to bargain.
Fucker hung up on me. Release the kid. See if we can flush the daddy out.
Better find your daddy, kid.
Does anyone have eyes on Niles?
Negative.
Go, you go.
Thank you.
on, kid. Show us where your father is. Anything?
Nothing. No eyes on target.
Mark, come here, buddy.
Fuck it. Just shoot the little bastard.
Come on, buddy. Come on.
Not paying $400 for aspirin. $400 for aspirin? $400? Are you guys kidding me? I don't have insurance. What happened to affordable health care? You better get your supervisor. You better find the president. Somebody needs to come to this counter and talk to me today because I'm not leaving.
Ma'am, I'm just a temp. The receptionist will be back sometime later. She's at lunch right now.
I need a doctor. It's okay, bud. Look at me. You'll be fine, okay? I said I need a doctor! Now! You're okay. You're gonna be okay, okay?
Daddy!
I got you. You're all right. I'll be right here.
Don't worry, sir. He's gonna be okay.
I'm right here, son.
It's a standard procedure. Every time you have a gunshot victim,
yeah,
you need to make a report. You understand?
Yeah, I understand.
Let's start with your first name. What is your first name?
Look, I don't have time for this, okay?
It's just company policy. We have to get this report done.
I know, I understand company policy, but let me explain something to you. My son is down there. He's been shot, okay?
Sir, just let me help you, okay? I just need this for the report.
Okay. All right, fine. Go ahead.
Security. Yes. It's for you.
It's for me. Hello.
Hey, Johnny.
How's little Mark? Hold on a second. Hey, buddy, it's my father. He doesn't know about this yet. Can you give me a couple seconds, please?
Sure, make it fast.
I appreciate it. Yeah.
Johnny,
you know how this ends, don't you?
I did everything you asked me to do.
What are you doing?
Johnny, be careful. You don't want that guard
to hear too much. All right? It might be hazardous
to his health. You don't want his
death on your conscience now, too, do you? Yeah.
That's right. Watching everything. Now look, you turn yourself over to us.
And I let your family live. This just ends right now. You touch my family, I swear to God, I'm gonna kill you. I know, you'll kill me.
Your family's lives are in your hands, not mine. Now the police
are on their way, and your family can't afford for you to get arrested. Now you take out that guard.
And you take his cell, all right?
Yeah.
We'll be in touch.
Ciao. No, he's gonna be fine, eh? Yeah, don't worry. I'm here with him right now. And she knows. Yep. No, it's gonna be okay, Dad. I promise.
Weston, Captain wants to see you.
You want to see me, Cap?
Sit down. Your perp just hit the number one most wanted list.
We have just been informed that American John Niles has been identified as the prime suspect in this morning's attempt on the life of
President Ford. It is believed Niles, also known as Stephen White, was formerly a special forces operative who later worked within one of our government's anti-terrorist units. Exact details have yet to be confirmed.
We had him, we had the cell phone, we had him.
This is going to get out of hand. Every badge, every patriotic nut job is going to be looking for this guy. His life expectancy just dropped about 1,000%. I want you to get him first.
Captain, we're going to be under a microscope with this.
I don't care what the press says. I want you to get this son of a bitch. You hear me?
Dead or alive?
I don't care. Either way or both.
I got it, Captain.
Get the fuck out of here. Waters, get in here. Now! Sit down.
John Niles has been identified as the prime suspect in this morning's attempt on the life of President Ford. It is believed Niles, also known as Stephen White, was formerly a special forces operative who later worked within one of our government's anti-terrorist units. Exact details have yet to be confirmed.
I thought we had an understanding.
Sorry about this.
Niles is to kill the president, and you're to kill Niles. He never should have made it off that rooftop, Marino. Niles is God knows where, and God knows who he's talking to. If he starts running his mouth off, you can forget about the decommission of the CIA. We're done. We're through.
So I'll be over soon.
There's not going to be any trial. We're not going to spend in a few couple of years in Club Fed. This is treason. Fix it, Marino. Fix it.
We need to start reducing his options. I want everyone with a gun and a badge after this shithead! Well, what are you waiting for?
Excuse me, Detective Weston with the PD. I'm looking for the head of security. Thank you.
What the fuck does John Niles have that he needs to hide in a storage unit?
Yeah, can you get me through to the Secret Service?
Please hold. Yeah, this is Thompson.
Hello, Detective Weston here. I'm investigating a case that involves the prime suspect in the presidential shooting.
What can I do for you, Detective?
Well, we just discovered that John Niles has acquired a substantial amount of firepower from a storage locker.
How is that possible when he is on every agency's and police force most wanted list?
Listen, maybe you can read about that in a report written by somebody who has the time to write it, but right now I'm more concerned about why he wants that firepower. You see, I haven't heard anything in the news about the president's condition, so I'm assuming he's still alive, which worries me that maybe John Niles is going to try and finish the job.
His condition is classified, and I'll take what you said under advisement, Detective. But rest assured that the president has sufficient protection from both the Secret Service and Homeland Security. We don't need city police clouding the issue with their theories and ideas.
Okay. You're right. The president's already been shot, and you guys have been doing a fine job. Congratulations. These fucking assholes.
This is Pete.
Yeah, Pete, it's Tom. I meant to get back to you earlier. You have any news on the victims in the warehouse explosion?
Listen, the explosion didn't leave us much to work with. It's gonna take a while for the lab to piece together anything from the remains.
Yeah, I ran the names that you gave me,
and nothing came back on our systems. Not even a parking ticket.
These guys are a little too clean, if you ask me.
Maybe you should try the CIA.
You think these guys are spooks?
I don't know what to think.
Weston, I wish I could, but I don't have access to their systems.
Pete? You may have to break a few laws, okay?
All right, man. But you owe me.
Thanks.
Someone has got to find me John Niles.
Sir.
What? Can't you see that I'm talking?
I think I got him.
I want this guy dead.
Understood.
We got a hit on our guy. We got a hit on Niles from two separate street cams.
Fucking beautiful. Finally, a break.
Hunt, run now! To the broken window, go! Hurry up! I'll meet you there!
That was a pretty ballsy move. Non-lethal shot.
Well, maybe I was just rusty.
Oh, bullshit. You just guessed there was a second shooter. But you've won nothing here, John. This doesn't change a fucking thing. Mission isn't complete.
Don't
Let's go, down the fire escape.
Okay, please take her.
Take her into custody. Take her into protective custody. I'll take care of this fuck. Come on, boss. Let's go. Come on. Tough guy, huh?
John Niles, I did that for your own safety to make it look real. You're lucky someone didn't shoot you dead back there. You really know how to ruin a man's day, John. I spoke to forensics. It's going to take like a year for them to fill out the report of everything that you've done.
Yeah, well, if they're looking for the answers, they'll find them. The truth is out there. I just draw attention to it. That way they couldn't cover it up.
You know, that's an interesting theory, but another man might say that the guy who shot the president decided to go to war with the CIA.
My family's okay. That's what matters. And I need 24-hour protection on them. That includes Mark in the hospital. You understand?
I already got a man at the hospital. But I doubt you're going to be able to talk your way out of all the shit you've done today. Now, I spoke to the doctor. He said your son's out of surgery. He's going to be okay.
Thank you.
So he's not dead?
No, he's not dead. Because I'm a soldier, not an assassin. But he's lucky it was me on that roof. Otherwise, he would be dead.
That'd be pretty hard to prove.
Yeah? Why don't you come look in my pocket? Maybe it'll help you out a little bit. I'm working with Homeland Security.
Time to set the dogs on Mr. Niles.
Once Niles is dead, we move forward. The president doesn't leave him alive.
Listen to me. Something's not right.
It's a road work. They're working on a fucking road. Calm down.
I'm telling you, it's not road work.
Hey, come on, guys. PD, you gotta let us through.
Hey, just let us make some room.
Weston! 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 Weston!
Hey!
Weston!
It's about time.
Hey, I was shot.
But you're wearing a vest.
It still hurts.
I should have went to the FBI. You got better body armor.
I take it you believe me then.
I believe they weren't here to take you alive, John. So what's your play?
Go to the hospital, save my son. Stop him killing the president. That's the play.
They kill every treasonous cop-killing bastard along the way.
Only one problem with that. My face is plastered all over the news. I can't just walk through the front doors.
I got it. You got it. Mike. You still got that relative in the fire department?
Weston, we just got word from the Secret Service director. They're moving the president today.
I mean, this is David's last chance. Once the president gets on Air Force One and lands in D.C., he's untouchable.
Shit. The only window they have to get him is before he leaves the hospital.
Nah, security's way too tight on this floor. They'll never get to him.
Maybe they don't have to actually get to him.
What do you mean?
Maybe they just have to get close to him.
What floor's he on again?
The same as your son. Shit, come on, let's get ready. Come on, put your feet up.
Slow down.
Here. All right, get the end. Ready?
Excuse me.
Yeah, I'm Detective Weston, LAPD. I got a prisoner here. I gotta get him checked out before I take him upstate. Can you help me out?
Right this way. Okay, so we'll put him here in room A for now, and we'll send in a doctor as soon as we have one ready. Mm-hmm.
Ma'am, excuse us, please. The president's on the next floor. Go.
Get down.
Move.
Shit! Fire alarm. We're gonna be locked down. You guys split up. See if you can find another way off this floor.
Yes, sir. Copy
that. Let's go.
Take the stairwell, go. This is Thompson on 5 with the president. The fire alarm's going off. You need to secure the room right now. Secure the whole floor. Send me 5 more agents.
POTUS is secure.
Detective Weston of the LAPD. We are under attack. We're at the St. Rose Hospital. Send backup. Send every fucking thing you have. You guard every fucking agent in the zone. Fuck!
Fuck this. I'm waiting for backup.
Things are yours. If I get to the president first, at least we have some hope.
You sure of that?
Here's what I am sure of. If we don't get there quick, we're going to be screwed. Because you know what? To the untrained eye, it looks like we're shooting our way in.
You're not making me feel very safe, Charlie.
Shot twice in one day, John. Go fuck yourself.
You'll live.
What are you waiting for? Go get the motherfucker.
Fuck.
Hey, fucker.
Back off, Johnny. Bravo. Hold it right there, pal. Pulling that fire alarm was a nice touch. I didn't expect that. But now you're stuck in here with me. This is a detonator. And your car is packed with enough Semtex to blow this place to fucking hell. So let me tell you how tomorrow's headline's gonna play out.
Please do.
After his botched attempt on the life of the president, John Niles went on a killing spree, which included several CIA agents, secret servicemen, and local law enforcement personnel. Niles then returned to the hospital on a suicide mission, intent on killing himself, his son, and the president of the United States.
A suicide bomber? That's your plan B?
Sometimes a great sacrifice is necessary. And you know what? You're still the Patsy! And I'm gonna die a hero!
Over there, bud. Huh. I think we got a little Picasso on our hands, son. Let me see.
Daddy kicked bad guy butt.
Yeah, Daddy's definitely kicking bad guy butt.
Oh.
Wow.
What did you say?
Daddy's kicking bad guy butt. Yeah.
You know he's yours.
No. He actually comes from your loins. That's correct.
You know what I think we should do? I think we should take these two pictures of Daddy's butt kicking.
Yeah.
And put them in a very special place, and then we'll take this picture and put it on the fridge.
I think we should do this on the fridge. Yeah.
Special place.
Yeah, okay.
So I'm just gonna take these two right here, and then let's take this one over to the fridge.
Good job, bud.
Very good job. Come on.
Yes. Hey, Bryce.
Turn the TV on, Channel 7.
Channel 7? All right.
Good morning, America. Today we are here to honor two men who have not only demonstrated great strength of character, but remarkable bravery. Their willingness to put their lives on the line and in harm's way, to save my life and the lives of hundreds of Americans by preventing a terrorist attack on American soil is nothing short of inspiring.
Well, the guy Weston's looking pretty photogenic after you gave him all the credit.
Well, they couldn't exactly pin a medal on you for shooting a president, could they? Besides, you two are a good team.
By the way, there's only three people in the world to take that shot. President should be grateful that I was one of them. And I'm the one that should be getting the medal here. You know what shrapnel pulling out of my ass right now?
Yeah. Are you bored of your day job yet?
Oh, no. I'm not bored at all.
I got something a little bit special. Could use your expertise.
Okay, let me guess. So you can give all the credit away, right?
Absolutely. At least tell me your thing about it.
Okay. Thanks for nothing.
All right. I'll talk to you.
Looks great. Perfect. I still like daddy kill bad guy look.
I'd like to introduce to you America, Captain Jake Barlow and Detective Thomas Weston. two true Americans.
Thank you, Mr. President. You're doing my job.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, sir.
We are just glad that we could be in the right place at the right time to protect you, Mr. President, and the American people. And remember, Barlow for mayor, 2016. Thank you, Mr. President.
There you have it. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for joining us today. May God bless you, and may God bless the American public.